Here's a completely free and no limits method you can use to improve the quality of any image, whether it's AI generated art by something like Midjourney or just plain old low quality images that you want to enhance. Keep watching because I have a solution for you. Hi there, I'm Memory and today I'm going to show you how you can improve the image quality of your own images by using a completely free and open source software. But there is a catch which I'll touch on in a moment. The awesome tool we'll be using to upscale images is called Upscale and is available for Windows, Mac and Linux. Upscale uses AI models to enhance the quality of images by guessing what the details could be. Currently, it uses the real ESRGAN model, or however you pronounce it, with more models that could be added in the future. Now, the only catch to Upscale is that you'll need a dedicated Vulkan-compatible graphics card to perform the image upscaling. Upscale, unfortunately, won't work with most integrated graphics cards or CPUs. But the good news is, there's no harm in testing it on your computer. It just might work. To download Upscale, you can head to their website and then download and install the correct version for your operating system. Once you've launched Upscale, you'll see the main window and let's start by having a look at all of the different options and how to use it. The first thing you'll see here is the Batch Upscale button, which we can use to upscale multiple images at once. I'm gonna leave that unchecked for now. We'll come back to the batch upscaling a little bit later. Let's start by selecting an image. Here, I have an image that I created with the Bing AI image generator, which currently has the resolution of 1024 by 1024, as you can see it listed in step 4. After selecting the image, you'll need to select the upscaling type. I suggest you play around with the different types that are available to see what works best for you. For this tutorial, I'll be using the default model, but at the end of this video, I'll show you comparisons between the different styles. After selecting the upscale type, you can also choose to double upscale the image, which will upscale it 8 times and will also take a bit longer than the default, which is 4 times. They do mention that the double upscale method won't work that well on high resolution images, so it's best to use it with lower resolution images. If I select this double upscale option, you'll notice the output resolution changes that's listed in step 4, so you can have a look at this to determine if the output resolution will work for you. Next, you can choose a path where the upscaled image should be saved to. By default, it'll be saved to where the original image is saved on your computer. Before clicking on upscale, let's have a look at the advanced options. Here, you can choose the format the image should be saved as: PNG, JPEG or WebP. And this is most probably the only setting you would want to change here. You can choose a different theme for upscale and you can also enter your GPU ID here. If you want more info on this, check out the frequently asked questions on the Upscale GitHub page. But for most of you, just leave this blank. And lastly, there's a donate button in case you would like to support the awesome creators of this app. Now, to start the upscaling process, click on upscale and wait for it to finish. I have an RTX 3060 12GB graphics card, and the 4x upscaling usually takes less than a minute to complete, with the 8x upscaling taking around 2 to 3 minutes at most. By the way, if you're finding any value from this video right now, please click that like button. Thanks! Once it's finished, you can drag the slider to see the difference between the two images. At first glance, it might look like the difference is minimal, but if you click on the image settings button and change the zoom, the difference is clearly visible, especially if the original image is of really bad quality. You can find the upscaled image in the same directory as your original image, unless you chose another save location in step 3, and it'll have a new file name with the settings that you selected applied to it. Now, let's have a look at the batch upscale method, which will save a lot of time for some of you. With this turned on, you can select an entire folder of images to be upscaled. At the time of this recording, it seems that you can't select the double upscale method when upscaling a folder of images. So I guess that means it'll only be upscaled 4 times and not 8 times. Change the output location if you wish and then click on upscale. The upscaled images will then be saved in a new folder in the same directory that the original folder is saved in, unless you chose another save location in step 3. Now, as promised, here are a few comparisons between the different styles that are currently available in Upscale. Upscale is easy to use and does an amazing job at image upscaling. It's almost unbelievable that it's free and open source and that it works on all the major computer operating systems, provided that you have a Vulkan compatible graphics card. If this video is useful for you, then remember to give it a like and let me know in the comments below if you have any questions. And if you haven't done so already, subscribe and ring the bell to discover more awesome free software and other tech-related stuff brought to you by Midjourney.